So every year I do one of these videos toward the end of the school year, usually when we're finishing up the year or when we're pretty close to being done. And I basically say whether or not I would buy it again, if I got my money's worth, if we hated it, if we loved it. Basically, do I have any regrets? And that's what we're gonna do in this video, and this is going to be for my sixth grader. Okay, so I'm back at my desk. I've got my coffee. And I'm hoping to make this not too long of a video here because we have sports and stuff today. It's a Saturday, so I don't have a whole lot of time, but I did want to make this video because we are getting to the end of the school year. It is already almost April, and it might be April when you see this video. So I feel like it's really important because everybody's buying curriculum right now. So I'm going to tell you my thoughts on what we used for grade six. I'll do a video for my high schooler as well, but not in this video. It's just too much for one video. All right, let's just start with language arts because that's easy. So I am eclectic when it comes to homeschooling curriculum. If you have not noticed, I basically piece things together. So you will see curriculum from all over. I don't do out of the box curriculum, meaning I don't do one brand for all my subjects because I found that it just doesn't work for my kids that way, and I just kind of custom build things. So you're gonna see a lot of different brands spread out here. Don't worry, it works out. Okay, so for spelling, we use Abeka. And I have used Abeka since the beginning for spelling. I find that their no-nonsense, simple approach is just the best for my kids. I have tried other things. I think I've tried every spelling curriculum out there. None of them really stick. My kids usually hate the methods that the other ones use. They just like the whole, give me the list, I'll memorize it and spell it type of thing. But there's also the spelling rules and poetry in these that you can use too. I usually go over the spelling rules. We don't do the poetry. But Abeka has made my kids into excellent spellers. So I don't see us really deviating from here. Totally got my money's worth. I buy these used and it's super cheap. So for our reading curriculum, we really piece these together. So my sixth grader is using Redefining School as his main reading curriculum. So with Redefining School, he is learning all kinds of things. He's reading short stories, he's reading poems, he's doing all sorts of different literature components. And after this, they do these really cool like coffee house meetings. It's all over Zoom, but it's really cool. So like I'll make him a special treat and everything. And then, you know, all the kids are showing off like what their moms baked them or what they made themselves. And it's a really cool thing. And then they read, you know, literature, they discuss literature, they read compositions that they wrote. So he's doing all sorts of really cool things with Redefining School. And I'll leave the link for Mindy's class. She is the teacher, she's awesome. I'm gonna leave her link down below if you wanna sign up. I think she's actually open right now, like total coincidence, but she only launches it like a couple times a year, so you can't just like buy it whenever you want. You have to get in. And once you're in, like you're in, but I will leave that down below. So that's his main reading curriculum, but we do a couple things together as well because he's a very strong reader. My son is, he moves very quickly through reading. So we are also keep up with these from Abeka. These are Lee's reading comprehension skill sheets. I love these, especially if you are like me and you live in a state where you have to do testing at the end of the year. These really help prepare him for the testing and things like that. So the other thing that we did, which was kind of, I don't want to say that it was really, really structured this year. Maybe it was just because it's our first year. Maybe it's because I'm lazy, I don't know. But we also did Teaching the Classics. Now, Teaching the Classics is a method. So this whole system is for the teacher. I have a whole video on this if you want to go check this out. So basically you buy these video instructions and it teaches you how to teach a book to your kids. So it's instruction by an educator to make you an educator for your kids. And we read several books this year. We read Sleepy Hollow, we read The Bronze Bow. We just finished The Bronze Bow, and that one was really good. We had kind of a kink in our schedule because we had my son's ITP going on, and we didn't read for a while from our scheduled books, so we just held off on that for a while. But we read 3 books this year with teaching the classics and doing that method. Really cool. I really like it. Okay, so let's talk composition. And when I say composition, I'm talking about writing. Most of you guys know I love structure and style. I do. I absolutely love and adore structure and style. They do not have a structure and style like online curriculum for every single year. Like, there is not a 1 through 12. So with that, that means that I have to do something after he finishes structure and style until he gets to the next level. So that's where we're at right now. So at the beginning of the year, he finished up his last online structure and style course, and then we had to move to something else. And I just wanted to try something else. So I did try the Narnia books. Now, Narnia is one of his favorite series, like one of his favorite book series. So I had high hopes for this. This was not for us. Like, it's not for me. This one was a little bit more difficult for me because the instructions just did not seem clear as far as like what to do each day. And I think that drove me a little bit crazy because I'm type A. Now, if you like to do things on your own and just kind of go with the flow, I think this would work for you. It's me, it's like a personality thing with me. I need like more structure, and I'm telling you, I think that stems from when I was a teacher and we had like everything laid out for us like day by day. That's why with stuff like this, I feel kind of like a lost little lamb here. I don't know sometimes what I'm supposed to be doing. So I know I'm doing the right things. It's just, I don't know if I'm teaching it the right way sometimes, and you know, I don't know. And I feel like on the good side of things, it did challenge my son in writing. He is a good writer. Structure and style made him a strong writer. But some of these assignments were a little difficult. Now, level 2, because he's almost at the end of level 1, is actually for high school. So we're not going to actually be doing that one following this one. I believe we're going to be doing another structure and style level, like one of the video instruction levels that he likes. So I'm happy about that. Okay, another IEW, and then I think we're done with language arts. Fix It Grammar, absolutely fantastic. I love the new updates. We've been using the new updated book all year, and I'm just flipping to the back here. They have the actual, I don't know if you can see it because of the sun, but the actual composition area is right here on the worksheet, so you don't have to have like a second notebook, which is really nice because I have notebooks just floating around here, and it seems like every time we would do Fix It Grammar, the notebook would go missing and then we'd have to spend 10 minutes trying to find the notebook. So again, probably because I'm lazy and disorganized. But okay, just a few more things because he's only in 6th grade. All right, for science, we did Apologia. I really, really liked Apologia Science. This one, I was not sure how I would do with physics. This was my first physics class that I had to teach. So this was very interesting. This is chemistry and physics together. I feel like I learned a lot in this class. We really did have fun though. And Nature's Workshop Plus sent us the kit of everything to do all the experiments. And that was really fun. I really enjoyed that. My son loves the Try It stuff in here. There's these little boxes that say Try It, and it's like a little mini experiment. And sometimes there's like one on the page, and sometimes there's like 2 or 3, and they're like really small things, like making a screw or just basic things to demonstrate whatever they're talking about in the text. I loved it. And I'm sad because this is like the last elementary level that my son is going to do before he gets into like the big, much more complicated Apologia books, and I'm like really sad about it because like all the cute stuff is over and now he's into, you know, more complicated things, which he's totally ready for. It's just me, you know, I just want to keep him a baby sometimes. All right, last 2. Okay, I've been singing its praises all year long, and you guys know I just love it. We're doing Generations History. We are doing the Taking Europe for Jesus. I wish I would have known about them like forever ago, so we could have started the entire series from the beginning. So those of you with little kids, I am so jealous that you get to do all of the levels and I don't. But I love the Generations workbooks. I love the textbooks. I think I'm in love with everything from Generations. I would buy their entire website if I could. So I have the main history textbook, which is so pretty. I have a review and a flip through of this on my channel if you wanna go check that out. And then they get the teacher workbook, student book in one here. It's so easy and it only takes like 15, 20 minutes. And that's sometimes even with discussion. So, you know, they read the chapter for Monday and Tuesday and then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, it's doing activities and projects and fill in the blank type of questions, making sure they understood it, that type of thing. We've learned so much about European history throughout this book and about all the reformers, and it's been just a blast to go through. I think my favorite part of the year was definitely history. The last class, zoology. So we are taking a zoology class from Campfire Curriculums, and I bought the In the Eyes of a Zoologist, and he's using the growing level. He's in grade 6. And then he made his own little student notebook to go with it where he takes his notes, because they teach how to do note taking in this class, which he needed so badly. I had no idea how badly he needed. I have a review and flip through of this on my channel as well. I purchased this after we came home from the hospital because I just wanted to kind of bring him out of his little funk, and that did it for sure. That totally did it. He has had a blast in this class. I have learned a lot. I think we both have just really enjoyed zoology. He's learning a lot, and even through this class, I have found out that they offer zoology courses at our college through our little tiny local zoo, which is more like a farm, but you know, small military town, you know. But you know, he's thinking about going into that career field, and I think that that's a really cool way to find that out. So he has been taking notes. He has been learning so much. He's learning all about taxonomy, and this week we learned all about eggs and egg embryos, and I think we start lesson 7 on Monday. So yeah, we're really enjoying it. I love it. So what would I buy again? I would buy probably everything except for the Narnia. That's probably the one thing I would leave out. So I would buy all of this. I'm happy with all of this, except for this one. This one would just not for me as an instructor. I think my son has loved learning more about Narnia and kind of going into that world more and learning more about C.S. Lewis and learning a little bit more about World War II, which is really cool that they tie all that in here. I you know, that's really cool. My problem is just the way that the instructor book is kind of set up, I guess. Maybe it's just because of my background and because I just haven't sat down and gone through the whole like teacher instruction of IEW structure and style. Maybe that would help, I'm not sure. But this one I probably would swap out for something else. I'm not sure yet what, but maybe something else on the IEW website. He's so good with the IEW stuff. He understands that language. I don't want to pull him out of that method, but I did not like the way that this was set up. So I would probably pick something else. But you'll never actually see me like support something and lie about a curriculum and not be honest about it just because I make affiliate commissions. I don't make enough money to lie like that. So I'm gonna be totally honest. Plus you guys see everything that we use, you know, via social media. So it really wouldn't do me a whole lot of good to lie about it because you guys are gonna see it anyway and you're gonna call me out on it. So yeah, I feel like we definitely got our money's worth with all of them. I feel like everything here was definitely worth the purchase. I don't have any major complaints. And a lot of them we've been using for a long time as far as their brand. So I'm pretty familiar with that brand. The new to us brand this year was Generation. So I did not know how that was going to turn out. It could have gone either way. But as you've seen, I've been buying Generations everything. So it's pretty obvious it's working for us and we really like it. But, you know, just in case there was any question about that, I did want to put that out there. All right, guys, that is my review of grade 6. And we are almost out of clothes. We have to do our state testing in a couple of weeks. So yeah, I live in one of those states. I live in the Carolinas, and we have to do like a state test every single year. We just make it into like a day and just get it over with, you know. I don't like to focus too much on it because I'm not teaching them for the test. I don't really care what the test says. We just have to do it for legal reasons. So, all right, I will see you guys in the next video. I hope you have a great rest of your day. And of course, happy homeschooling.